Chief Meteorologist Alan Seals with your First Alert Storm Team forecast.
Well, there in the middle of the screen, the center of attention as it should be. A Category 3 hurricane, Hurricane Michael, with hurricane force winds limited, fortunately, to a small area, even though it's a very strong storm. But the tropical storm force winds do go out a couple hundred miles. It is a broad storm, and it will certainly have impact. The motion remains northward at 12 miles an hour. The maximum sustained wind, 125 miles an hour. Do remember, that's 5 miles away, technically, from being a Category 4. It is going to fluctuate in wind speed, so don't focus so much on the category. Just focus on the fact that it is moving steadily toward the northern Gulf Coast. Right now, about 200 miles offshore when you talk about the eye of the storm. There you see the rain band. Two areas right now where the threat of tornadoes will start to increase, and of course the threat of flooding as those move inland toward the coast. Yes, the Gulf of Mexico is warm, as it always is in hurricane season, warm enough to support a hurricane. And offshore, the wave heights, 20 to 30 feet close to the middle of the storm, 15 feet if you are, say, 80 miles offshore. Compare that to Hurricane Ivan, which was a Category 5 out in the Gulf. It had wave heights of 50 to 60 feet. Nonetheless, this is a strong system. Here's your forecast projection, still on track from what we've been saying the last day and a half, heading toward the Florida Panhandle, somewhere between Apalachicola and Destin, Florida. Landfall, speed, could be a Category 3, could be a Category 4, but if you look at the time from Wednesday morning to Wednesday evening, halfway in between, you're basically talking about Wednesday afternoon. Sometime the center of the storm crossing the coastline very close to Panama City, Florida. People there have got to be prepared. The worst weather is most likely going to stay east of Destin, which is not to say Destin will not have bad weather, but farther westward into Mississippi, things would be relatively unsettled, and that's all relative. From midnight tonight with an east wind for everybody to 7 o'clock in the morning, there you see those outer rain bands very clearly, the eye of the storm offshore before noon. Around noontime, getting close to landfall, if it stays compact in terms of the hurricane force winds, they would be limited to that area you see right around the eye. But it's possible it can expand, just like the rain can expand. And you may have noticed that most of the impact is close to Panama City and Destin and Apalachicola, not so much in the News 5 area. Once it makes landfall, it starts to weaken and rapidly head to the northeast, so that by Thursday, it's going to be a dry northwest wind, lower humidity. It's going to be a bright, calm day. But first, we've got to get through the stormy day tomorrow. These are your winds projected from midnight tonight to just after sunrise tomorrow. Notice inland counties, you're not seeing anything extreme. That's why we haven't talked much about inland counties. But after the sun comes up, look at the winds in the panhandle. They shift out of the northeast, 40 miles an hour, 44 miles an hour in Apalachicola. They go to tropical storm force in the morning, and then by the afternoon, they go to hurricane force close to where the storm is projected to make landfall. Westward, everyone has a north wind blowing out toward the Gulf of Mexico. Not extreme if you are inland, but you will still have wind gusts. Steady winds in Pensacola in the afternoon, 38, 40 miles an hour. Most of those locations are not going to see extreme weather, but that steady wind can still knock over trees that are weak. It could still knock over tree branches and take out power to a subdivision. And that's part of the reason why you still have the tropical storm warnings for South Mobile and Baldwin counties, as well as Connecticut County and Escambia County in Alabama. Even the Mississippi Gulf Coast has a tropical storm watch. But the hurricane warning area, that's where the impact is most likely to be felt. In the storm surge watch, you can see a couple to several feet of storm surge, depending on the wind direction. But in that storm surge warning area, you could see 6 to 9 feet of storm surge. That could be deadly. We know already we've got some coastal flooding due to the east wind that we have. But overall, it's not going to be a very wet storm for the Mobile Bay area. The heavy rain falls closer to Destin. Apalachicola, it could be 8 to maybe 12 inches of rain, and tomorrow that's where the threat of tornadoes is going to be. Hurricane Leslie still lives. Tropical Storm Nadine stays harmlessly in the Atlantic Ocean. Neither of those is a concern to anyone on the Gulf Coast. Tomorrow is the concern. Beyond tomorrow, though, if you're not in the path of this storm, get ready for fabulous fall weather with nights falling into the 50s.